Welcome to Highline Excel 2013 video number 6. Hey, if you want to download this workbook for week 2, click on the link below the video. Hey, in week 2, we're talking all about formulas and functions and cell references and formula inputs. So here we built this budget last video. I can see very clearly I'm using these percentages. These are expenses as a percent of revenue. And I'm using all these formula inputs in this whole table. So any intersecting cell here, I can see I'm pointing down here. Now why, for this calculation right here, why am I pointing down to this 22.5 instead of actually hard coding it right into the formula? Because I can do what if analysis. So what if I'm like, in the budget meeting, wage expense, it's not 22, it's 27%. And as soon as I type this here, the whole table will update instantly. So what if analysis? That's why Excel was invented, right? Now here we have a budget. I just did Control-Z. And this is one set of assumptions. But I may have one or two or three sets of assumptions. And instead of having to go through and change each individual one when I'm having discussions in my budget meetings, we can simply save a set of formula inputs using the scenario manager, save a couple different sets, and then easily change between the different sets. So I'm going to highlight this range here and save this as a set up on the data ribbon. What if analysis? Scenario manager. Boop. There are no scenarios. I'm going to click Add. Because I've highlighted the cells, it has the changing cells right here. And I'm going to give it something like Set 1. You could call it Budget Set 1 or something like that, but I'm going to call it Set 1. Click OK. You have the opportunity to change it right here in this dialog box. I usually don't do that. I'm going to click OK. So we have a set here. Now watch this. I'm going to come here, and I'm going to change these. So this is now 27. This is 6. This is 4, 27, 3, and 8. This is a completely different set of assumptions. I'm going to highlight. And actually, there's if you do this a lot, there's a keyboard for it. Now, we learned about Alt keyboard. So if I hit Alt, I can see that data is A. What if is W, and S is scenario. Now, notice that's three keys. If you do this all the time, you can use the old 2003 Alt keyboard. It used to be Tools, drop-down menu, and then E for scenario. So now with the range highlighted, Alt-T-E. And I'm going to say Add. And because I have some new numbers there, I'm simply going to type Set 02. Click OK. So now I have two sets, and I can switch back and forth between them. So I can say Show, and instantly I show there. Show. And we'll see how to add a button here in just a moment. Now another cool trick, what if we had some percentages and we just wanted to increase them or decrease them by some amount? Well, 1.1. If I multiplied 1.1 times each one of these, it would increase that percentage by 10%. Well, there's a great trick. It's a pay special trick. If we copy this cell, highlight these numbers, and go up to the Home, Paste button, drop down, and Paste Special. You got to be kidding me. Down here, there's this thing called Operation. And whatever you have copied, you could add it, subtract it, multiply it, or divide it for all of the numbers highlighted. So guess what? We're going to multiply. Now, it will actually change the numbers here. One problem, though, is if we do it right now, because we're pasting something, it would replace all the formatting. So I'm going to say, hey, do values only. So on the top for paste, values from the operation, multiply, and click OK. And just like that, we have increased all of our percentage by 10%. Now we can save this as a scenario, Alt-T-E, Alt-A. And then I'm going to type Set 03, click OK. Click OK. Click OK. Or close. Now I'm going to delete this. We don't need this here. We would like to add a button up here so we don't always have to go up to that data ribbon scenarios, which is fine. I mean, it's certainly easier than typing everything out, right? But now let's go to the quat, right click, customize, quick access toolbar. We're going to go to not popular, but all commands. Click in somewhere in the list and type in S, and we want to go down, try and find the scenario. So I'm going to put this scenario button. Scenario manager will get you the scenario manager dialog box, but I'm going to click this scenario button, add. Click OK. And so now right up here, I have set 1, set 2, set 3. Scenario to save formula inputs, totally awesome. Even add a button, and also our paste special to increase a number of budget percentages by a certain percentage. All right, we'll see you next video.